Good morning, everybody. Today we'll have an explanation of our novel, A Tale of Two Cities. Its abbreviations from chapter 16 till 20. If we'll have a look, أنا عملت لكم سؤال وجواب بداية من 16 ل 20 عشان دنيتكم تبقى سهلة ونعرف نذاكرها بسهولة جدا إن شاء الله. Sequence of events. Number one, what made Dr. Manette write that letter? And how did he write it? If we'll have a look, he wrote the letter in the year 1767, meaning 10 years after being put in prison. يعني بعد ما اتحط في السجن بعشر سنين, يعني هو موجود في السجن. He began to write the letter when he lost hope of coming out of prison. As we know, anybody who enters the pastel not to be out of it until he was dead. So he lost hope. He began to write the letter when he lost hope of being set free. يعني hope of coming out of prison. And when he noticed he was beginning to lose his reason, يعني يفقد حقه يعني. He wrote the letter at intervals with rusty nail as a pen. ده اللي هو how did he write it. He wrote the letter, كتب الجواب at intervals, على فترات with rusty nail as a pen. He used a rusty nail, مسمار مصدي, as a pen, and his own blood mixed with soot from chimney as a ink. لو حبيت اركز شويه في كلمه سوت اللي هي عندي دي, اللي هو الدخان المتصاعد من chimney المدخنه. So he used a rusty nail as a pen and his own blood mixed with a this soot from chimney as a ink. يبقى what made Dr. Manette write the letter? Lost the hope of going out of prison. How did he write it? Use a rusty nail as a pen and his own blood mixed with soot from the chimney as ink. Number two. What was written in the letter which Monsieur Defarge had found in the room 105 North Tower? Let us see. The letter was written by Dr. Manette, as we said before, when he was in prison. In that letter, Dr. Manette cursed the Evermont family. يعني cursed لعنهم لأنهم كانوا the reason of a making him يعني have this long imprisonment in Pastel. They were the reason, they were behind his imprisonment. In that letter, Dr. Manette cursed the Evermont family and explained how they were the cause of his imprisonment. He described the two Evermont brothers, اللي هما twins, اللي اخوات Evermont, had caused the death of, كان الناس دي السبب في موت مين, sister with her husband, father and brother. اللي احنا بعدين هنعرف ان دول الفاميلي بتاعت مدام ديفارج. They had also put Dr. Manette in prison for a long time without having a trial and without any guilt. اتحط في السجن بدون أي محاكمة وبدون أي ذنب. لو افتكرنا في البدايات خالص في أول two or three chapters, there was something called a lettre de cachet. It was like a privilege from King Louis to the noble people. They can send anybody to prison without any trial. دي كان ميزة كينج لويس عملها للنوبلز, الريتش بيبل, الناس الغني, أي حد يتحط في السجن بدون محاكمة. يبقى they had also put Dr. Manette in prison for a long time without having a trial and without any guilt. And so they caused the separation between him and his wife and daughter, between him ومراته ودوتر اللي هي لوسي, she was still a baby. At the end of his letter, Dr. Manette hoped that God would show no mercy to the Evermont family. Should no mercy to the Evermont family, اللي أنزم ربنا ينتقم منهم. As they had no mercy on a people. يبقى this was written in Monsieur, in Dr. Manette's letter, which was found by Monsieur Devarge in Dr. Manette's room, 105 North Tower. Number three. Who visited Dr. Manette on the day after the death of the woman and her brother? Why did the visitor wish to help the dead woman's sisters and family? On the day after the death of the woman and her brother, a young lady visited Dr. Manette. راحت له بيته. She was the wife of the younger brother and the Darnes mother, مرات الماركي اللي هو of Evermont. راحت لدكتور مانيت اللي هي دارنز مازر. She was not happy in her marriage. B. She had discovered the main facts of the story of the woman and her husband. كانت عارفة حقيقة موت الناس اللي ماتوا دول. Whose death the twin brothers had caused. اللي كان الإيفرمون family اللي هم twin brothers السبب في موته. She didn't know that the girl was dead and wished to help her in some way and to help her younger sister too. The doctor did not know where the younger sister was. الدكتور ما كانش عارف ال younger sister كانت فين اللي هي مدام ديفارش وهي صغيرة. She told the doctor that she wanted to do all she could. She اللي هي wife of the Marquis of Evermont اللي هي Darnay's mother. She told the doctor that she wanted to do all she could for the cruelly wrong family. She wanted to help them because she was afraid lest these wrongs should become a curse to her son, who might be, المفروض دي بي اي مش بي ار, who might be forced to pay for them someday. كانت خايفة على ابنها انه هو ايه يدفع ثمن غلطات ايه العيلة بتاعته, والغلطات دي تصبح ايه a curse to her son, لعنة على ابنها. Number four. What was the people's reaction after letter was being read? جواب ما تقرا رد فعل الناس كان ايه. What was the verdict? وكان ايه الحكم القضاء. After the letter had been read in the court, the people cried for the blood of the Evermonts. طلبوا ان هم يموتوا. This is the meaning of that sentence. The people cried for the blood of the Evermonts. The verdict was to be put to death and galt without 24 hours. الحكم إنه هما كان يتشنقوا خلال 24 ساعة. Number five. How did Darnay try to comfort Dr. Manette when he felt guilty? Darnay told Dr. Manette that he knew how he suffered when he knew the real name of Darnay. Darnay قال لدكتور مانيت ان هو عارف how much he suffered اما عارف اسمه الحقيقي ان هو تشارلز إيفرموند not تشارلز دارنيه. يبقى دارنيه told دكتور مانيت that he knew how he suffered when he knew the real name of دارنيه and how he overcame his feelings for Lucy's sake. يعني عارف الحقيقة تغلب على مشاعره عشان خاطر ايه لوسي loved تشارلز دارنيه. Both Lucy and دارنيه thanked the doctor and asked God to help him. Let's move to number five. Number six. What happened to Lucy as Charles Darnay was drawn away? Who helped her? As Darnay was drawn away, Lucy cried and asked to touch him for the last time. And after being allowed to do so, بعد ما تم السماح لها, she stood watching him walk away. Then she fainted, أغمى عليها. Khartoum picked her up and carried her to the carriage. Number seven. What did Dr. Manette intend to do? كان ناوي يعمل إيه? What did he decide to do? Was there any hope? وكان في أمل? Dr. Manette intended to see some people in power. Dr. Manette decided to see some people in the high court. يدور على بعض الناس اللي هم إيه in big positions. And try to save Darnay. But there was no hope of saving Darnay's life after the way by which the people showed their feelings. No one could dare save him. We will move to number 8. Why was Lucy to be told that her child and father were in danger, not she herself? She was to be told so because she would gladly sacrifice her own life and stay beside her husband. But if she knew that her father and child were in danger, she would go for their sake. Number 9. What happened to Dr. Manette? When he returned to Mr. Lurie's room, he looked very sick. It was clear on his face that he could not save Darnay. يعني أغلب محاولاته فشلت. He had returned to his condition. رجع لحالته القديمة، الحالة المرضية. When Lucy found him in the garret and he asked for the shoemaking tools and the bench. As we know, زي ما احنا عارفين ان دكتور منات when he returned to his old mental and physical condition, he loses his memory and begins to ask for his shoemaking tools as a shoemaker and his bench. ما بتجي له الحالة اللي هي القديمة اللي كانت عنده. Number 10. Why did Carton go to San Antoine? Carton went to the wine shop because he wanted the people to know that an Englishman who looked very much like Darnay was living among them. Number 11. On what point did Monsieur divorce and his wife disagree? On what point? لأي حد؟ لأي مدى كان في اختلاف ما بين Monsieur divorce ومدام divorce اللي هي تريزا divorce في وجهات النظر في مسائل معينة. مدام divorce insisted on the extermination of the Evermont family. مدام divorce مصممة على extermination, destruction, تدمير عائلة إيفرمونت to the last of their race, لآخر واحد في العيلة ما يفضلش حد في العيلة. While Monsieur Defarge did not want to cause Dr. Manette any more suffering. Monsieur Defarge ما كانش عايز أي معاناة تحصل لدكتور مانيت تاني. So Monsieur Defarge asked his wife to be satisfied with the execution of Darnay. يعني كفاية إن إيه دارني هيتعدم. Let us move to number 12. Then tell when the fire were to stop, but don't tell me. It's a very important comment. دي مدام ديفارج ما كانت بترد إيه على ميسيو ديفارج. These words were said by Madame Defarge to her husband after she had revealed to Jacques number three, and the Vingians her secret. A woman called a Vingians. Revealed what? Revealed that the family of the woman and the young boy who were cruelly wronged by the Evermont twin brothers was her own family. يبقى الكلام ده قالته لجوزها إما كشفت لجاك number three والأذر woman اللي هي Vingians السر إن العيلة اللي عانت من ظلمهم وناس كتيرة ماتوا منهم بسبب ظلم الإيفرمونت twin brothers دي كانت عيلتها. بدأت توضح she hated them إنها بتكرههم so much that she decided not to stop taking revenge. مش هتتوقف عن الانتقام منهم until the whole of the race was out from fire لغاية إيه آخر واحد في العيلة ما يموت عايزة تولع فيهم كلهم. Number 13. Why were Lurie and Carton anxious? ليه الاتنين كانوا very worried الأنين. They were anxious and worried since Dr. Manette left at 4 o'clock to make a final effort to save Darnay. الأنين من ساعة ما دكتور مانيت خرج من الساعة 4 محاولة أخيرة لإنقاذ حياة دارني. But hadn't returned back yet. Number 14. What was the paper they found in Dr. Manette's case? It was a certificate enabling him. Certificate اللي هي شهادة معناها هنا إن هي ورقة معتمدة يعني. It was a certificate enabling him تساعده هو و his daughter Lucy و her child Lucy الصغيرة to pass the barrier and the furniture at any time. ورقة بتديهم إمكانية to pass إن هم يعدوا الحواجز أي وقت من مكان لمكان. Number 15. Why were Dr. Manette and his family in danger? ليه كانت حياتهم في خطر. دكتور مانيت and his family were in danger because Madame Divorce had decided to announce Lucy and little Lucy as enemy. يبقى had decided to accuse Lucy and دي معناها accuse Lucy and little Lucy as enemies of the Republic. إن دول أعداء للريبابليك. And the woodcutter الحطاب was ready to testify. كان مستعد إن هو يقدم شهادته that he had seen her making signs to the prisoners. Number 16. What were the arrangements agreed between Carton and Mr. Lurie? إيه البلان الترتيبات اللي كانت ما بينهم؟ أول حاجة Carton gave Lurie the written permission which allowed him as an Englishman to leave Paris. He also gave him the paper that allowed Dr. Manette and his family to pass the barrier at any time. B. Carton asked Lurie to have a carriage ready to leave Paris at 2 o'clock the following day. Carton told Lurie to make sure that Lucy, her child, Dr. and Lurie himself were seated in the carriage ready to depart for England as soon as Carton himself joined them. Carton told Lurie to tell Lucy that if her husband last wish that she and her father should leave Paris at once, they were in great danger. بدي الترتيبات اللي هو إيه قال له علي. Number 17. الشابتر بتاعنا اللي هو 52. Why was the chapter headed 52? ليه كان entitled, ليه كان التايتل بتاعه 52؟ ليه عنوانه كان 52؟ Because there were 2 condemned prisoners awaiting their execution that day. لأن كان في 2 convicted prisoners. في 2 مسجونين مدانين. أو 2 found guilty. 2 وجد إن هما مذنبين. 2 سجناء مذنبين. Awaiting their execution that day. منتظرين حكم الإعدام في اليوم ده. Number 18. For whom was the letter Carton dictated to Darnay really mean? How do you know? طبعا dictated معناها instructed. It was really meant to Lucy because he referred to the conversation they had together and indirectly reminded her of his promise to sacrifice his life to keep a life she loved beside hers. Number 19. How did Pross help Lucy and the others to get away? Realizing هنا معناها حقيقة that Madame Divorce might cause Lucy to be brought back to Paris. بنرجع للحقيقة إن Madame Divorce might cause Lucy to be brought back to Paris and she reported that they had fled. Fled يعني escaped. Miss Pross refused to let her enter Lucy's room and tried to detain her. Detain, look, يعني تحجزها, تمنحها as long as possible. She realized that the longer she detained Madame Divorce, the better was their chance to escape. Number 20. What was Darnay thinking about when he was alone in prison? What did he do? Darnay had no hope when he was in prison. He knew that he had to die. And fish عنده أمل وخلاص حط في دماغه إنه المفروض هيتعدم. بس اللي كان مزعله أكتر, he had to die not for a crime of his own. جريمة ما عملهاش بإيده, but for crimes committed by members of his family. بس هيتعدم بسبب جرائم ارتكبت بواسطة أفراد من عيلته and other families اللي هم rich people إما الثورة. He was not ashamed. ما كانش خجلان because many people innocent like him died by the guillotine. لأن في ناس كتيرة أبرياء زيه هاي يموتوا بالمقصلة أو المشنق. He thought of those whom he loved. اللي كان بيفكر في الناس اللي بيحبها. Lucy وليتل لوسي بنته ودكتور مانيت ومستر لوري. 21. How did Carton persuade Darnay to obey him? إزاي convince Darnay إنه هو يطيعه by telling him that he had come from Lucy with a request to do exactly as Carton directed him. إنه هو جاب له ورقة من لوسي إنه هو يسمع كلامه ويتبع الانستركشنز بتاعته كل اللي يقوله بالزبط. Number 22. What did Carton order Darnay to do? طلب منه. He ordered him to take off his boots, to put on Carton's boots, يبدله اللبس, and to exchange his cravat, كرافات اللي هي التاي اللي هو الوشاح اللي بيلبسوه, with Carton. He took off the ribbon of his hair. ريبون اللي هو شريط أو وشاح بيتعمل على إيه الدماغ كده, and shook Darnay's hair like his own, بحيث يبقى الاثنين نفس الشكل. 23. What did Carton do after he had drugged Darnay? عمل إيه بعد ما خدر؟ He buttoned Darnay's coat and tie, لبس المعطف بتاعه والتاي بتاعته, to put on Carton's boots and he put on Darnay's coat and tie, compact his hair, سرح شعره لورا زيه, tied it with Darnay's ribbon, ربط شعره اللي هو نظام دي الحصان ده. Then he called for Parsett to come in and take Darnay away. نادى على Parsett ان هو ايه يخرجه, يبقى اللي فضل جوه الزنزانة Carton ودارني اللي ايه خرج, هو بدل لبسه معاه بحيث يبان اللي ستيل في البريزون ده Darnay, ولكن في الحقيقة هو Carton. واللي خرج مين؟ اللي خرج في الحقيقة Darnay, بس لابس لبس Carton على اساس ان Carton ايه اللي خرج عشان ما حدش يشوف. 24. What did Madame Defarge intended to do and why? She intended to act alone against Darnay's family because she was afraid that her husband might warn Dr. Manette if he knew her plan. كانت مقلقة من جوزها إنه هو عشان بيحب دكتور مانيت, وانت دكتور مانيت not to suffer, إنه هو ما يعنيش ممكن يقول على إيه حاجات من خطتها ويحذر. 25. Why didn't Madame Defarge have confidence in her husband? ده اللي احنا كنا لسه بنقوله. ليه مش عندها ثقة تامة في جوزها بالنسبة للموضوع بتاع عيلة دكتور مانيت؟ Because he didn't have the same reasons that she had. لأنه مسيو ديفارج جوزها ما كانش عنده نفس السبب اللي عندها لإيه كراهية العيلة بتاعت إيفرموند. يبقى because he didn't have the same reasons that she had for hating that family and wanting to destroy it. He also felt sorry. جوزها felt sorry, كان بيشعر بالأسف على دكتور مانيت. ليه؟ Because he was servant. لأن في البدايات زي ما عرفنا إن مسيو ديفارج he was an old servant, كان خادم أيام زمان long time ago عند دكتور مانيت. عشان كده دكتور مانيت لما طلع من السجن هو رد له جميل وخده and put him in one of his rooms اللي هي كانت in a building in front of his wine shop. كان بيرد الجميل لدكتور مانيت. يبقى هي اللي هو مسيو ديفارج also felt sorry for Dr. Manette because he was his son. Madame Defarge could not tell her husband about the details of her plan. ليه؟ قلنا ده زي اللي قبله بالظبط. She feared, كانت خايفة, he might give them a warning and so they might escape, ممكن يحذرهم ويهرب. 26. Who was going to help her and why? The woodcutter الحطاب by witnessing إن هو يشهد يقدم شهادة against Lucy and saying he had seen her making signs and signals to the prisoners. Jack 3 was going to help by swaying the opinion of the jury men. برضو Jack 3 كان كمان هيساعدها إن هو swaying. بالنسبة لسوينج هي معناها ان هو ايه يأثر على الجوري اللي هم هيئة المحلفين, يأثر على رأيهم يخليهم يغيروا رأيهم. يبقى جاك 3 was going to help us swaying the opinion of the jury men in the court في المحكمة against her. 27. Why did Madame Defarge go to Lucy? She went to her because she thought that some more evidence of Lucy's hostility. Hostility اللي هي واخده معنى dispute, اللي هو خصام او عداوه to the Republic could be obtained. In Nahia, she visited her at once when she was grieving her husband's death. She would be likely to talk about the unjust verdict, الحكم القضائي غير العادل, against Darnay. Madame Defarge could use Lucy's words against her. 28. What happened when Madame Defarge tried to force her way into Lucy's room? Both women struggled and fought. Both women, اللي هم مين؟ Madame Defarge and Miss Pross. Madame Defarge drew her pistol, شدت مسدسها, and Miss Pross tried to knock off her hands, حاولت تشده من ايدها. The gun went off. الرصاصة طلعت, and Madame Defarge was killed. اتقتلت Madame Defarge أثناء الفايت ما بينها وما بين Miss Pross اللي كانت بتحاول تحمي لوسي. 29. سؤال مهم. We discussed both Miss Pross and Madame Defarge were determined women but in different ways. Discuss. Number one, Miss Pross loved Lucy and her family. That love filled her heart with courage to save her. كانت بتحب لوسي وعيلتها. الحب ده ملأ قلبها شجاعة ان هي تدافع عنهم وتحميهم بكل ما أوتيت من قوة يعني. But Madame Defarge hated Dr. Manette and his family, which made her wanted to get rid of them all. عايزة تتخلص من العيلة Madame Defarge. Number two, Miss Pross knew that Madame Defarge was their enemy while she was their friend. As Miss Pross getting ready to leave, she found Madame Defarge in the middle of the room. لسه Miss Pross خارجة لقت Madame Defarge في وسط الأوضة. Madame Defarge spoke French وPross بتتكلم إنجليزي. Madame Defarge spoke French while Miss Pross اللي هي they didn't know each other. Miss Pross بتتكلم إنجليزي فالاتنين مش فاهمين بعض, بس البادي لانجوج الصوت العالي بتاعهم وحركات العينين والكلام ده بيدل إن مدام ديفارج جاية تنتقم. فميس بروس كانت فاهمة. يبقى مدام ديفارج spoke French while Miss Pross spoke English. They didn't know what each of them said, but their intentions, النوايا اللي هي البادي لانجوج اللي أنا بقول عليها, their intentions were clear. النوايا كانت واضحة. Number three, مدام ديفارج started calling Lucy as wife of Evermond. قعدت تنده على لوسي يا مرات إيفرمون. But there was no answer. ما كانش حد بيرد. She started looking everywhere. قعدت تدور في كل مكان لغاية ما جت عند أوضة معينة وميس بروس وقفت قدام إيه باب الأوضة. But Miss Pross stood in front of Lucy's room to prevent her from entering. Then started to fight Miss Pross. مسكوا في خناق بعض. Miss Pross killed Madame Defarge accidentally. يعني عن طريق الصدفة. As both women struggled and fought. Madame Defarge drew her gun. الصفحة اللي قبلها قلنا ممكن نقول gun, ممكن نقول pistol. It's okay. Miss Pross tried to knock off her hand. شدو. The gun went off. انطلقت الرصاصة. Madame Defarge was killed. Third. Why couldn't Miss Pross hear any noise in the street? بعد ما حصل المشكلة اللي بينها وبين مدام ديفارج وانطلقت الرصاصة مرة واحدة, فبنقول ليه ميس بروس ما عادتش عارفة تسمع كويس. Because the explosion of Madame Defarge pistol had made her deaf. Explosion معناها انفجار, بس هنا أثر صوت الرصاصة المدوي كان جي جنب ودنها وهي بتشد المسدس فخلاها يعني إيه ما بتسمعش, شبه ما بتسمعش. دي معناها هنا. 31. Whom did Carter meet in prison? What did that person ask him? Carter met a poor dressmaker who was supposed to have met Charles in LaForce prison before him, في السجن اللي قبل كده, when he was arrested for the first time in Paris. She was accused of making plots against the Republic. طبعا بلوتس هنا معناها اللي هي المكائد, مؤامرات يعني. Carter had pity for her, أشفق عليها, when she said she was ready to die if that was useful for the Republic. But she said that she was poor awake, so her death was no benefit for the Republic. اللي هي كانت بتقول ما عنديش مشكلة ان انا موت عشان الريبابليك, بس انا فقيرة وضعيفة, موتي مش هيفيد الريبابليك بأي حاجة. So asked Darnay to hold her hand to encourage him. And as she raised her eyes, saw his face. إما دققت رفعت عينيها وبصت في وشه. طبعا هي كانت عارفة دارني اللي قدامها ده كارتون وكان عامل دور دارني إما كان إيه مسجون. فأول ما بصت في وشه وما كانوا تسجنوا مع بعض قبل كده في لافورس. أول ما بصت في عيني وشافت وشه she was astonished. Astonished يعني اندهشت جدا. Very surprised because she knew that he was not Charles Darnay but another brave man. رجل شجاع آخر who was dying for him. بيضحي بحياته ويموت مكانه for the sake of his wife and a child. 32. Why did Carton look peaceful when he was facing his death? كان شاعر بالسلام الهدوء النفسي وهو ايه facing his death اما جه يتشنق ويموت. He looked that because he was satisfied and happy to sacrifice his life for Lucy's sake. حس ان هو عمل حاجة كويسة في حياته وان لوسي هتبقى سعيدة وهو ضحى بحياته عشانها. البروميز اللي هو كان وعده بيها ايام زمان. يبقى he looked peaceful because he was satisfied and happy to sacrifice his life for Lucy's sake as his sacrifice would give him an honor. ده هيبقى شرف. هيديله شرف a sacred place. سكرت هنا معناها respectful place. مكان محترم. In the hearts of the descendants of that family. لي هنا معناها للأجيال الجديدة بتاعة العيلة. يبقى أنا لو ركزت في الجزء بتاعي ده لو ركزنا مع بعض هنلاحظ إن إحنا ده عندنا زي ما قلت ده ملخص من شابتر 16 لشابتر 20 نقرأ بتركيز ونفهمه. حتة إن إحنا نحفظه لا not advisable ما انصحش ان حد يحفظه. انا اعمله لكم سؤال وجواب نقراه ونحفظه نقراه ونفهمه كويس will be better. وهنلاقي ان شاء الله الجزء الاخير بتاع القصة بتاعنا ايه مفهوم. go through one by one. انا اعمل لكم sequence of events تسلسل الاحداث تشتغلوا عليها و I hope إن كل حاجة بالنسبة لكم دلوقتي clear. مفيش أي إيه مشكلة عند حضراتكم في A Tale of Two Cities. وإن شاء الله بعدين هننزل لكم كمان في نهاية شهر 12 illustration على إيه A Tale of Two Cities. Okay. Thank you and have a nice day. Wish إن أنتوا فهمتوا كل إيه حاجة.